This guy here is the master of the buggy. He can slap it on you from anywhere. In a moment, Dragon's going to tell us how he slapped it on him. And I was there watching. It seemed about 1.25 seconds is all it took to slap a buggy choke on Dragon. Not once, not twice, but three times as they rolled around the other day. Here he is.
170 pounds for Tye Ruotolo.
But you're doing next something good, Dragon.
Look at those arms. It's the length of those limbs. He's able to snatch up submissions from all angles.
And now, his opponent, also representing the USA, Garry the Lion Killer Tonon.
A face familiar to mixed martial arts fans and to submission grappling fans, the USA's Garry Tonon stepped on the scale.
169 for Garry Tonon!
Oh, Mitch, this is going to be killer, and there's a grudge, there's a rivalry here between these two.
Oh, look at them, posing in front of each other, ready. They've been talking back and forth. I really like this matchup. Both these guys are innovators in their field. One goes after the legs, one goes after the neck. This one will surely end in a finish. Look at Tonon, no handshake
there. Ruotolo! The man with the crazy dust choke. It's been his favorite technique since he was a kid. Since he started training as a three-year-old, wasting no time in walking to the circle for the first time, Dragon, stomping to the circle.
Yeah, he's kind of already warmed up, but I got to wonder about the adrenaline dump. He just cornered his brother and he was screaming, he was animated. Do you think that's going to factor into this match, Buchecha?
No, not at all. I think he uses that as a warm-up. So I think, yeah, he didn't need to warm up because the adrenaline from watching his brother helping him to be warm and ready to go for this one.
A BJJ black belt under Andre Galvao. Reached fourth place at the ADCC as a 16-year-old. A five-fight win streak, including two BJJ world champions that he has beaten. Ruotolo says he's been watching Garry Tonon since he was a young kid.
You kind of glossed over that, but reaching fourth place at the ADCCs as a 16-year-old blue belt, Buchecha, what kind of deal is that?
It's a big deal. ADCC is something that it's a tournament really hard, and for 16 years old, you know, he may have like men's strength already, and you getting fourth position is something unbelievable.
After losing his world title shot against Tan Lee, Tonon is back in his jam, back in his comfort zone, back in submission grappling. Lots of memorable main wins in his grappling career, including Dylan Dennis, Harlan Gracie, Vinny Margulies, Gilbert Burns, Imanari, Shinya Aoki, who he heel hooked in 2017. A 6-week camp for the Lion Killer to prepare to defeat Tye Ruotolo.
Oh, the Tonon is back in the house, and grappling no less. I thought he was going to mixed martial arts full time, but I love watching this guy grapple. Buchecha, what's the biggest thing that Garry Tonon brings to the grappling world?
His submission game. I think he just couldn't watch the grappling thing he's seen on the inside the cage and be watching out of sight. So I think he's, no, no way. That's my division, I'm jumping in. And that, I think, was his, in his mind. He didn't want to stay to just watch this at home.
Talk to me about his leg game. How has his leg game changed the grappling world?
Yeah, just like I said, he grew up watching him, and Garry doesn't really care about points or anything. He just go for the kill.
Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he stands at 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds, holding a BJJ record of 14 wins and 6 losses. Training out of Aptos, representing the United States of America, Tye Ruotolo! Introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 169 pounds, holding a BJJ record of 72 wins and 26 losses. Training out of Team Henzo Gracie and Evolve MMA, representing the United States of America, Garry the Lion Killer Tonon! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Mohamed Sulaiman.
Athlete, center, please. All right. You both know the rules, all right? Let's keep this clean, keep it active. You have 10 minutes. Let's go for submission. Touch hands if you want. Back to your corners.
Circle to nine. They stare each other down, and here we go in this All-American battle.
Tonon immediately takes the center circle, but Kate again with a change of levels. Uchecha, haven't you fought Garry Tonon? Did you have experience training with, or fighting, competing against Garry Tonon?
Yeah, it was a long time ago. I didn't even knew him at the time. It was 2013. At my first ADCC, it was the first round, so.
And you're a heavyweight.
Yeah, he just doesn't care. He goes there to fight against anyone, anywhere. So that's Gary's style.
Exactly. He's a huge risk taker, Michael. Garry Tonon will put himself in dangerous positions if he thinks it will give him an advantage. And I expect to see that here tonight.
Ruotolo predicted a das or a rear naked choke finish, and a difference in approach here. Gary smiling, maybe trying to get inside the head of Ruotolo. Ruotolo, though, all business.
Yeah, Tonon is having fun out there. He enjoys this. He has so much experience in this world. This is his home. You can see how relaxed he is, but he's not really attacking quite yet. Is he just being too comfortable, Pichecha?
Yeah, he's waiting. He's waiting to see how the kid gonna push the pace. And 10 minutes is a long time, and he knows that, so.
Tonon typically likes to work for longer matches. He likes to take his time and be in there, but Kate is immediately putting on him. Let's see if he can get the first guard pass fall into north-south position. You like this position, right? This is your jam right here. Uh-oh, he's got a darts locked in.
Right there.
Uh-oh, that looks like an anaconda.
Looks tight.
That's a legitimate attempt right there, ladies and gentlemen. Garry Tonon's got to move.
Oh, my. So the first 2 minutes, how do you do? How about that? Tye Ruotolo submits the lion killer, Garry Tonon. Pushesha, talk us through this.
He controlled his neck, and I think Garry didn't expect it. He tried to go for the kill so fast in the beginning of the fight. But look how he trapped his leg. That way, Garry couldn't roll away, so that was really impossible to defend a choke. If he got the leg away, he would be free, but Tye knew that. So.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohamed Sulaiman, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 37 seconds, declaring the winner by way of Darce Choke, Tye Ruotolo!
Incredible. And a highlight reel finish for Tye Ruotolo inside of 2 minutes.
Woo! I am here with your winner, Tye Ruotolo. That was ultra fast. Did that go down exactly how you thought it would?
I'll be honest. When I first took the match, I thought it was going to take me about 6 or 7 minutes to get the sub. And through fight week, I was, you know, sizing up Garry, and I realized, you know, it was going to come a bit quicker. So, as to be expected, you know, me and my brother got a killer dart, so I was stoked to pull it off tonight for sure.
Yeah, that was ultra fast. As soon as you found the position, you were able to slide that arm in there and lock it up. What was going through your mind once you got that cinched up there? Did you know that was a wrap?
Yeah, it was perfect, the technique, the positioning. So I just knew I couldn't burn out my arms, you know, kept the same pace, and I got the tap. You know, super grateful to have the match with Garry. He's a beast, a legend of the sport, to be honest, for sure. So great win over him. Thank you.
Yeah, you're calling it a darce, but wasn't that an anaconda? Didn't you come in on the next side?
That was a darce, actually. That's my signature. That's the one.
Look at this. Look at the way you lock this thing up. Your arms are so long. Look at this. I mean, you were able to sink it in. Talk me through this.
Yeah, I mean, I guess I got him down, got him up against the cage, made it kind of hard for him to back out. And I set it up pretty good, I guess. Yeah, got the tap, so super stoked.
Oh, man, it was a thing of beauty. You barely got any work in. You know what? You know, from martial artist to martial artist, that man right over there, Chachri Sidyatong, has just given you a $50,000 bonus.
Oh, my God.
How you feel about that?
Unbelievable. Unreal. You know, I worked my whole life for stuff like this. And I'm just so stoked, man. My grandpa Lloyd, ever since I was a little boy, you know, he's such a big fan of MMA, and he's been watching my brother and I compete. And, you know, he's up in heaven right now, but for sure, this is his dream to watch us doing this here. And how to get the 50,000 debut, fight, got the sub. I'm so stoked right now. This one's for Lloyd. I love you.
Well, I'm sure he's looking down, and he's real proud of you. But it was ultra fast, no damage. How soon you want to get back in here?
I actually took more damage before the match. My brother was warming up, headbutted me. I got a little blood on my arm. But man, I want to get in. I'll get in tomorrow if I could. I love this place. Yeah.
Yeah. What, did I hear Cade calling out Garry Tonon? Who did you say we wanted to do it next? Is that what I heard?
He thought I was the shittier brother, right? So I said we got to get one on next. So yep, if he's up for it.
Oh, that might be fun right there. What do you think about that?
That would be epic. You know, maybe I'll run it back with Shinya. Cade couldn't get the sub, so it'd be cool if we switched opponents. That'd be pretty crazy.
What a debut for the Ruotolo brothers, Cade, Tye. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your winner, Tye Ruotolo.
How about them, the fabulous Ruotolo brothers, both victorious tonight, and that was amazing. That was also amazing. Your commentary debut, Bushesha, was, you hit it out of the park. Thank you, brother, for joining us. It was an absolute pleasure. We'll see you again very soon.